Well, first of all, I'd like to introduce my honored guest, Colonel Don Bernstein. When you start to look at a perfect soldier, there is nothing perfect. But when you start to think of what he did during his days in the military, in combat, and you also talk now, when he's sliding down a little bit, he took over ROTC, that was nothing. And now we have young kids that are in college, going into ROTC, and all of them that talk to you about say, if it wasn't for him, I might be in a different world or what I'm doing. But this gentleman made a lot of us realize that we could be somebody. And so I was so honored when he said, I'd love to come up. This is a gentleman that, as a citizen, you're proud to have had this gentleman serve your country, because he put country before anything else.
Can you tell us about your service?
Yes, I graduated City College of New York. I went into the Army right away from the great metropolis, the Big Apple, and I was born and raised in the city. I'm basically an infantry officer and an Army aviator. Had an unusual career doing both. Most people do one, I had to do both. So while I was an infantryman, I had to fly. When I was flying, I had to do infantry duties. I served in Vietnam twice, and I flew classified secret intelligence missions. And I made my contribution there. I was in Germany twice, 2 3-year tours, and I ended up in the military at Old Dominion University as the professor of military science. And my last tour was at West Point, New York as the deputy post commander. 27 years of the military. And now I have 28 years in high school, junior ROTC.
And he's making young people assume responsibility and act as an adult rather than as a baby. And you know, I spent 23 and a half years, four years as an enlisted man and 19 and a half years as an officer. And when you see what happens in these organizations that have a project of not only having men in ROTC, but he opened it up, and these are young women who think, I'm as good as the rest of them. And he made everybody remember academics and soldiering go together.
And respect.
Huh?
Teaching respect.
I don't think he had to teach them respect, because they, after having an interview with them, because they didn't get to join the ROTC, if I'm correct, you interviewed everyone that was coming in.
Yes, we do that with the guidance counselors, yes.
And so he knew that these kids, and these were all volunteers. You didn't have to say, come on in, we'll interview you. These were people that said, I want to go to his class. I want to be trained by him. And parents, as I said on the floor, the parents were thrilled, because they knew here was a leader that was going to teach their child many things, etiquette, concern for others, human decency, and respect for one another. And he did all, and he's still doing it.
So what do you think about this day? Congratulations on your induction into the Hall of Fame.
Extremely surprising, exceptional. I'm going to remember this the rest of my life, to see all the people like myself from all the services who made this major contribution. And it just hits you right here in the heart. It's just wonderful. I thank Senator Larkin for nominating me.